Well, last night we told you about a young child who was killed after being struck by a car in a driveway. That car was being driven by one of the family members, and tonight the family relives that tragic accident. 4029's Monica Limpert has the exclusive report.
2-year-old Itasia Ewell was hit right in front of this apartment complex here on D Street in Fort Smith. And today the family has set up a memorial to remember their little girl.
She screamed.
Who screamed?
My baby.
It was completely unexpected.
The kids were outside playing. And my two older sisters left in the car and they came back and my baby was standing right there and they just smacked her.
Kanisha's two sisters were test driving this silver Pontiac. Her sister Kimberly accidentally hit the gas instead of the brake, pinning Itasia against this concrete porch.
I just see her there. She puts her little hand up and I tried pulling her and I couldn't get her. Then I tried again and then it just like automatically the car just released and I put her to the ground.
The family immediately called 911 and stayed by Itasia's side.
And Tay was laying across the side right there where the memorial stuff is. She was laying across it and I ran up to her and was trying to keep her focused on me. And she lost her breath or quit breathing and they started doing CPR on her.
Itasia was transported to a hospital where she was pronounced dead. Now, a memorial strewn with flowers and pictures of her is lit with candles to remember.
Beautiful, outgoing, lovable, energetic. The best baby you can.
Kanisha and her fiance Michael are expecting their first child together. They were looking forward to Itasia becoming a big sister.
I just wish Tay would be here to see her little brother and be able to play with her. I know I'm really going to miss her, and I ain't never going to forget her.
As for the family, it will be a long road of healing. Kanisha's sister has been in and out of the hospital, suffering from seizures and the shock of the accident.
I can't look at her. I don't hate her, but I don't know if I can forgive her.
No account has been set up yet, but the family is in need of help with funeral costs. Monica Lempert, 4029 News.
Police say they're still investigating the case and trying to find out if alcohol was involved. The driver of the car has been released from the hospital, but is still suffering from occasional seizures.